Good morning and welcome to the end of my first week at CodeClan in Edinburgh. It's another cold morning through here, albeit a wee bit drier, a wee bit bluer skies. So we're happy about that, no more rain. Gonna be getting a wee cheeky sausage roll from Greg's and a coffee, and we're gonna hit it there. Okay, so it's been a very, very productive week here at CodeClan, been settling in nicely. Every other member of my cohort's been really nice, super friendly. Couldn't ask for any better students to be in my class. So it's been a great to have such a mixture of different levels of experience and people from all different walks of life and different backgrounds in the class as well. Every day brings its own new challenges and solutions, and we start every morning with a stand-up. This goes through everything that we've done from the day before, any concerns anybody's got, any questions that anybody's got, or even just anything that anybody wants to ask in general. After the stand-up, then we jump back into the classroom, go over the previous night's homework, and then again ask any more questions that anybody's got. The instructors have been brilliant at being very patient with us, spending as much time as they need on any questions that any of us have got to get us the right answers that we need. So it's been great. The rest of the morning and then the afternoon is normally spent doing a code along or pair programming. Pair programming is also brilliant for getting to know not only your fellow cohorts, but the way they think, the way they tackle problems, and gives you another perspective on how somebody else would tackle the same issue that you're facing. Some of the fundamentals that we've been going over this week that are textbook in the world of any coder are Git and GitHub, and the importance of committing your work regularly so that you've got a constant backup of all your work and so that people can check your work when they need to. We've also been using Atom as our text editor and using all the tools available on Atom to run Ruby as our programming software. We've also learned about arrays, which are just ordered integer indexed collections of an object. We've also learned about hashes, which are similar to arrays in that they are still indexed collections of object references. We've learned about loops and why and when you would need to execute a repetitive piece of code. We discovered functions and variables and why it's really important to give them explicit names so that they tell us exactly what it is that they do. We've been using test-driven development, or TDD. I was so confused with this at the start because I couldn't see how in analogy terms it would be used in a real life situation. But now I can see the importance of why you would need to test your software before you could let it be used. This week's already went so fast and I've already learned so much, even if sometimes it doesn't feel like I have. If week two's anything to go by, I really can't wait. Thanks again for sticking around and watching my wee update for my road to code. And I'll update you again next week with another wee video. Cheers, see ya. Let's just pause that there because, to be honest, I'm no happy with it. Wait, what's going on with this focusing? There we go. I'm no happy with that. Just reviewing the week one video there, and it seems a bit static, a bit scripted, and a bit boring, to be honest. I started off well, but then it just turned to mush. So I promise next week it's going to be less scripted, more dynamic, less boring, and more on the fly. So check in next week for week two. Cheers, see ya.